Yo, what it do, YouTube? It's your boy Spray Paint back at you with another video. The other half of it's time for that Coach for the Street podcast. Hit that like button, man. So this video here is about King AK-47 live stream responding to DJ Academics calling him out about feeling iffy about 1090 Jake. You feel me? Now, like I said yesterday, I told y'all one thing about King AK-47. When it all boils down to it, he gonna roll with the facts. He gonna roll with the facts. He ain't gonna say nothing of it. But we ain't heard nothing from Seddie Nash yet. Now, that's mighty funny. So, you know, they probably might still be conversating with him on the cool or whatever. But like I was saying, not to get off subject, I told y'all King AK-47 was gonna call a spade, you feel me? And he said he had done warned 1090 Jake. The way that you grading people as snitching, it's gonna come back and bite you in the ass. And I'd be damned if it didn't. Because like I said, it's already been allegations of him calling the police back in the days, then turned around when he was in juvenile. He told because, you know, he got in a little small little ride. Now it's more paperwork, like for real. I mean, everybody want to yell that it's a grievance form. It's a grievance form. Nigga, at the end of the day, if we using convict terminology, that is what you call a kite. No other way around it. He rode a kite, and on the kite, it stated that he got bust in the head with a rock and a sock. You feel me? And he put Buddy name out there. So all you niggas started talking about, oh man, that was a grievance form. That don't count. Nah, that's that selective politic and shit. Y'all know that boy told. He could still expose rats, but he won himself. You feel me? He got to wear that jacket too. He in the same category as Terrence Gangsta Williams, Finesse two times, 03 Gretto, Young and Ace, Boston Richie, all them boys. And you quit to say something about Gunna. Only thing Gunna did was take a plea. But you, on the other hand, you told the officers in the grievance form who went upside your head with a rock and a sock. You is the police, my boy. So you can sit there and turn them comments all off on your IG all you want to. You still gonna get an ear full. You don't get away. You done ran up. You said you ran up $1 million. All paperwork. Well, these other bloggers, they finna run $1 million up off your ass too. Cause you ain't special. Like I said, it ain't no fun with the rabbit got the gun. All you had to do is get your bread and calm down. But no, you want to act like you ain't never did nothing in your whole life. Let's just keep it real now. Majority, not trying to be on no racist shit, but when it come down to these streets, majority of the white people that get caught, they tell, you feel me? Especially on the black man, they gonna tell on the black man before they tell on the white man. That's all facts, nigga. White folks been goddamn giving black people cell cases since I was legit, so we ain't gonna even get into all that. But yeah, like I was saying, man, shout out to King AK-47 for being honest and letting these people know that the dude that he had respect for, he did rat. You know what I mean? Y'all let me know what y'all think on that, but we finna get on to the next subject. But yeah, man, on to the next, man. Let's talk about ESTG. You feel me? One of the rawest football players out there that was doing this thing at the time, act like he got something against people bringing up his past. You feel me? Now, Bootleg Kev was interviewing this nigga a couple weeks ago. You feel me? And he was basically, you know what I mean? He was affirmative with the man and everything, bro. You feel me? And he was basically just, you know, asking basic questions like, you know, what made him go to Gotti, you know what I mean, instead of going to Gucci and things like that. And this nigga was just acting all arrogant and like a little broad you feel me, with his nose up in the air. Every time Bootleg Kev asked him something, he want to relate everything to the streets. You feel me? Like, come on, my nigga. If you're a real street nigga, you ain't got to do all that extra ass shit with your bald head ass, trying to act like you all extra gangster. But at the same time, nigga, you can't run away from your past. If you was a raw football player back in your time and there's highlights on YouTube, what you think the bloggers and the podcasters gonna ask you about? Nigga, they ain't finna talk about fit and all that shit. You know what I mean? On no motherfucking interview with you when you actually was a real superstar on the football team, but you wanna put on this gangster persona like you ain't never, like you just been in the streets your whole life stepping and rapping. Nigga, you don't rap about when your ass was on the football field, nigga. You ain't, you need to stop that shit, bro. Like, gotta need to tell you, like, you trying too hard. You feel me? Niggas from the street don't try too hard. Nigga, most of the niggas from the street, they trying to talk with sense so you won't think they from the streets. You dumbass nigga, you got them walk off the interview like the man say something about your mama. That man didn't say nothing but ask you about the highlights of your football career when you was playing football and you acted like you had a whole thong in your ass. You feel me? I ain't saying that I'ma stop playing your music. I love your music, but you, as a person, you a fucked up little nigga that think you hard. And ain't nobody gonna respect that shit because your ass was a football player too. Until you own up to what you was doing in the past, your fans ain't gonna acknowledge you. But y'all let me know what y'all think about that in the comment section, man. I'm gone.